Information in a schedule can be sorted and grouped in a number of ways, including a grouped or itemized list of elements in a model, or a calculated total of information such as area or cost amounts. First, create a schedule of the elements in the project. In this example, a furniture schedule is created. Add the fields to the schedule. In addition to adding fields associated with the furniture, you can add fields associated with the room where the furniture is placed. Add the room number and the room name. Use the Move Up and Move Down buttons to place the fields in the order they should display in the schedule. On the Sorting and Grouping tab, choose to sort by the room number. Select Blank Line to add a blank line in the schedule between the different groups of room numbers. Click OK to complete the basic schedule. The resulting schedule includes a line for every item in the project. The similar items can be grouped further. In the Properties palette, select Sorting and Grouping. Add an additional sorting parameter to group by the family name. Then clear the checkmark next to Itemize Every Instance and click OK. To see the amounts of each element placed in the model, add the Count field to the schedule. The cost indicated still reflects the cost of one element. You can specify to calculate a total so that the total cost for each row is calculated. Click Formatting on the Properties palette. Select the Cost field, and under Field Formatting, select Calculate Totals. To calculate the total cost for all elements in the model, check the Sorting and Grouping tab and select Grand Totals. Grand totals for columns in the schedule will be calculated. Use the drop-down to control which grand totals are displayed. If required, enter a custom title for the totals.